good morning, sir, and good morning, everyone. I'm Megan Sibilano, and my topics that I will be discussing is all about Fractal robots, Simputer, and diamond chips. But first, we will talk about Fractal robots. What are fractal robots? The fractal robots are a set of uniform electronic tools which are functioned by an operating system. These robots are imbued with hardware as well as software. The movement of these robots can be controlled by an embedded chip which is placed in the tool. The expected size of these tools ranges from 1,000 to 10,000 atoms wide. Fractal robot is a science that promises to revolutionize technology in a way that has never been witnessed before. Fractal robots are objects made from cubic bricks that can be controlled by a computer to change shape and to reconfigure themselves into objects of different shapes. These cubic motorized bricks can be programmed to move and shuffle themselves to change shape to make objects like a house potentially in 3 seconds. It is exactly like he is playing with little bricks and making a toy house or a toy bridge by snapping together little bricks, except that here we are using a computer. This technology has the potential to penetrate every field of human work like construction, medicine, research, and others. Fractal robots can enable buildings to build within a day, help perform sensitive medical operations, and can assist in laboratory experiments. Also, fractal robots have built-in self-repair, which means they continue to work without human intervention. Also, this technology brings down the manufacturing price down dramatically. So we will now proceed to the apparatus of fractal robot. Apparatus of fractal robot is steps, ways, procedures, or process on how to build this kind of technology or mechanism and how it will work. In other words, creating a fractal robot needs a plan or implementation to operate because fractal robots have programmable code that has an ability to move or operate this kind of technology. So we have 5 steps. So construction of fractal robot moving mechanism, computer control implementation, fractal operating system, and fractal bus. So the first one is the construction of fractal robot. The construction of fractal robot is not easy because one should take a lot of efforts in making these robots. The robot design includes the smallest amount of moving parts so that they can be mass generated. The required materials of this project made easy in the market, and the materials used to make this robot are plastic as well as metals that are obtainable in developed countries, whereas glaze and ceramic are environmental materials which are obtainable in expanding nations. In other words, construction of fractal robots is for the design. Then, the next one is the fractal robot movement mechanism. To monitor the inner system, the representation of the plates is the most essential thing. The motor assists the plates to drive in the slats as well as outer the slats. The motor can be used to run the pedals with the help of a metal strip. The movement mechanism for the movement itself of the fractal rubble. Third one is computer control implementation. The robotic cubes contain a microcontroller to do the basic operations such as the swap of information in the given method control. The essential equipment of a Fractal robot is the software. The computer control mechanism is the connection between the computer and the mechanism. So, the fourth one is the Fractal operating system. The operating system of a Fractal robot plays a vital role in the features of this system. The following objectives. First, the clear statement of the information. Second, data can be compared at every level. Last, the built-in self-repair awareness. The Fractal operating system is the brain of the mechanism, meaning the program to operate the Fractal robot. And the last is the Fractal bus. The Fractal bus is an important development for the Fractal PC, and it permits the hardware and the software to submerge into a single arrangement of data. It assists in transmitting or receiving the information, which is function with the Fractal features. And the Fractal bus is the continuation for the hardware and the software to go to a single arrangement data. So we will now next to Fractal robot movement patterns. There are several designing methods are available for use, and these come in various sizes. Although the movement methods are always similar. Apart from of density, the cube moves only between numeral positions and obey instructions to move right, left, forward, backward, up, and down. If the cube cannot execute a function, then it turns back. If it cannot perform that also, the software in the cube begins self-repair algorithms. The basic movements methods of these are classified into three, mainly peak and place, L-steamers, and N-steamers. Peak and place method. Peak and place is simple to know, and instructions are issued for a compilation of cubes advising every cube where to exit. An instruction of 517 cube shift two positions left those cubes in a single cube is moving in the whole apparatus. It is the one which is used to pick up an object and place it in the desired location. So it can be a cylindrical robot providing movement in horizontal, vertical, and rotational axis. A spherical robot providing two rotational and one linear movement. And articulate robot or a Scara robot. Second one is end streamers. A cube is pushed out from the outside and then an additional cube is shifted into empty space. The shifted cube is connected to the end of the rising rod and pushed out once more to the rising rod. For bridge construction applications, the tentacles are developed vertically for making tall posts. And the last one is L-streamers. L-form cubes are denoted with numbers, namely 4, 5, and 6. And these numbers are connected to a rod denoted with numbers namely 1, 3, and 3. A new cube 7 is attached so that the rod develops with 1 pin. The 6 and 7 cubes are shifted to the positions of 5, 6, and 7 to form an L shape. And that's all for the day. So let's move back to the second topic named Simputer. Have you ever heard a small computer called Simputer? Then if not, I will be discussing it to you, the meaning, the design, and the software of Simputer machine.
Thank you.
definition, diamond chip or carbon chip is an electronic chip manufactured on a diamond structural carbon wafer. It is the revolution in IT industry that replaces the need of silicon. So, a team of scientists led by Matthias Schwer of the University of Augsburg in Germany has developed a crystalline diamond film that could produce more resilient semiconductor chips than those made from silicons. Or it can be also defined as the electronic component manufactured using carbon as the wafer. The major component using carbon is carbon nanotube. So what is the carbon nanotube? It is a nano-dimensional lid by using carbon. It has many unique properties, such as the boron as the p-type, the nitrogen as the n-type. Diamond structural carbon is non-conducting in nature. Some of the carbon allotropes act as a semiconductor. It has less than a 1 nanometer diameter. The crystal structure of Lawrence Daley looks exactly like a diamond. So the carbon nanotubes are the strongest and stiffest materials yet discovered in terms of tensile strength and elastic modulus respectively. So, have you ever heard about digital jewelry or digital jewelry? Then let me introduce to you the digital jewelry. In ancient times, both silicon and germanium were used in the manufacturing of electronics components. Pure silicon and germanium are semiconductors in normal temperature, but later it is found that germanium has many disadvantages when compared to silicon, such as large errors carried, less stability towards temperature, etc. So in the industry focus on developing electronic components using silicon wafers. So yung digital jewelry, ito yung ano, yung dating ginagamit as a chip. Meron, kung napapanood nyo sa mga movie or sa mga nababasa nyo na book, yung halimbawa na lang na pintas, yung pintas na yun, meron yung chip. Ayun yung tinatawag na digital jewelry. So let's go now. Next to advantages and disadvantages. So the first one is the advantages of diamond chips. The first one is it overcomes the disadvantages of silicon at bulky size. It is of small size. Kasi yung silicon, maumbok, tapos yung ano, yung diamond chip, maliit lang. Then, the second one is that diamond chip was at the higher temperature. So, yung diamond chip, nag-work lang siya into the, dun sa mainit na lugar. Then, the third one is the diamond chip is faster than silicon chips. The last is diamond chip provides larger power handling capacity. Kasi yung diamond chip is lot stronger than the silicon chip. So the disadvantage of diamond chip, as expected, the diamond chip is costlier than the silicon chip, since diamond nga naman. Since it is a diamond, so it is expensive. Then, doping process is very hard to perform due to the diamond structure. Kaya mahirap siyang i-create kasi dahil sa mga elements na nasabi ko kanina, the boron and the nitrogen. Then, yun lang po. That's all for today. Thank you po.